Hi everyone and welcome to a video on cons preparation for CAT. This video is particularly for someone who is weak at mathematics or is not from a similar background. To give you an estimate of how uncomfortable I was with this section, CAT takes place in November and I took my coaching in January of the same year. But I started self-preparing for cons even 6 months prior to taking coaching. At that time, I took a mock just to assess my performance in the section. I was only able to attempt 8 questions and I got 4 wrong. People might tell you that CAT is all about 10th level mathematics and nothing more. But the truth is that even if you have studied mathematics till 10th, you still need to brush up your concepts. And how quickly you are able to do that will determine the amount of effort you need in this section. The first mock that I took taught me an important lesson. That in order to score better in this section, I'll need to improve my attempt rate as well as accuracy rate. A lot of people emphasize on accuracy rate but forget to tell you about the attempt rate. Let me give you a table to explain this. In the rows, you can see the number of attempts and in the columns, you can see the accuracy rate. Now let's take two scenarios, a person who attempts 15 questions with 100% accuracy rate. That individual is going to score 45 marks. But another individual with 25 questions attempted and 70% accuracy rate is also going to score close to 45. Now you tell me which one is more difficult, to maintain an accuracy rate of 100% or to attempt 25 questions. That's why my first target was to improve my attempt rate and the second one was to maintain an accuracy rate. I personally believe that a balance between both is very important. And that's how I have tried to structure this video as well. I'll share with you how I improved my attempt rate and accuracy rate both. For attempt rate, I tried to finish my basics and also changed my mock attempt strategy. And for accuracy rate, I maintained a formula book. Within the basics, I tried to self-prepare for 6 months and then I took coaching for a year. In case of self-preparation, I'll be talking about the books that I used, the timetable that I followed, and the process of preparation. So let's start with them one by one. I used Arun Sharma's book for QA. You can find its review in the suggested video above. I'm not saying this is the best book out there. You can use any book of your choice, but try to buy one book and choose any edition. Like even if it's an older edition, that's perfectly fine. What matters is not the book. What matters is how you use it for your preparation, which I'll be sharing ahead. Try to prefer a physical copy. And I did only LOD1 questions and from my experience, I believe they are more than sufficient during the self-preparation time. And if there is someone who is watching this video who wants to buy a book for self-preparation for QA but is probably not in a financial position to do so, I would suggest you to wait for at least a week. I'll be sharing a notification on the blog. Basis the ad revenue generated, there are some books that I can afford to send to some of the students. Look out for that notification. The next thing is timetable. So in order to decide how much I need to do every day, I used a backward milestone process. So I started in June and the first thing I did was to set a deadline, which was December of that year. And I decided that I would be finishing the LOD1 questions. So I quantified the questions. I noted down the number of questions in each chapter. And then I divided the total number of questions by the number of weeks I had left, determining the number of questions I need to finish in each week. A lot of people ask this question, how many hours do I need to put in to crack CAT? This is a wrong question to ask because ultimately you need to finish your syllabus. So determine how much syllabus you need to finish in each week. I have written a detailed answer about it on Quora. I have talked about a task table technique that I used to follow. I can share its link in the description. You can go through it in your free time. Let me now talk about how I use the book in the process of preparation. So I would first try to begin with a chapter by reading the concepts given before the questions. I would note down the important formulas and everything from there. And if I wasn't clear about a particular concept, I would definitely watch a video before beginning with the questions. Then I would start with the questions in different settings. So in a day, I would try to make sure that I'm solving 10 questions in one sitting, then taking a break, or let's say 20 questions in a sitting and then taking a break. This ensured that I was able to complete more number of questions than I would have if there was like a longer sitting of 30-40 questions. That drains a lot of energy. Another important point was regarding checking the solutions of these questions. So if you attempt a question and you check the solution immediately and you try to correct the course, it drains a lot of energy. Instead, if you attempt 10 questions, then you check the solutions of all the questions together to see your mistakes, and then you try to correct them. That way you are able to do more number of questions. So this was how I would attempt the questions of a particular chapter. And an important point here that a lot of people fret about: please, when you're beginning with your preparation, don't worry about a question that you're not able to get correct. The very fact that you began with your preparation is because you are not good at QA. So make sure that you're learning from each question. Even if you get 0 questions correct out of the 10 that you attempt in a sitting, that's perfectly fine as long as you understand how those 10 questions were to be solved. Because when you're beginning with your preparation, the agenda should be on learning from each question than getting it right in the first attempt. If you have some unsolved questions still, then I would recommend marking them for review and then probably trying to ask them on the different forums that are available, or take them up in the coaching institutes or the groups that are available online. With this, we come to an end of the self-preparation phase, and everything else in the video will move past very quickly, because once you develop a strong base, things start seeming a bit easier. In the coaching phase, I wanted to develop more confidence in this section, so I used the time basic material and Arun Sharma LOD2 of certain chapters, not all of them. In this phase, I initially started with a coaching pace, whatever the coaching institutes guided. But after some time, I developed a routine basis my own timetable approach. I will share a video above, you can check out the routine. Then I started taking mocks. So I took mocks from the very beginning of coaching, which was in Jan itself. And I will share a link with you in the description, which defines how many mocks I took in each month. You can refer to it for your own preparation. In this phase, I try to ensure that I gain more concept clarity, and I also try to treat it as a revision for whatever I had done in the self-preparation phase. But a point that I would like to mention here: coaching can only do so much for you. Ultimately, it boils down to your own effort of what you take from the coaching. So when you ask in the comments, how is this particular coaching center, or should I take coaching online or offline? Ultimately, it will boil down to your own effort, no matter which coaching institute you join. With this, we come to an end of completing the basic stage as a part of increasing your attempt rate. The other way to increase your attempt rate is by improving your mock attempt strategy. So I used a rounds technique, which is an attempt strategy for QA. I have explained it in detail in a post, which I'll share it in the description. The reason I'm not taking it up in this particular video is because currently I believe most of you will be beginning with your preparation rather than taking mocks at this stage. So let's take it up as a separate video sometime. This gives a closure to the attempt rate strategy. To improve your accuracy rate, you can use a formula book. So formula book is basically a repository of all your concepts and formulas. So in the process of preparation, when you go through the concepts, take up the questions and then check their solutions, you might come across some concepts, formulas or tricks in the solutions in the beginning of the chapter. You should note all of them down in a dedicated book called as a formula book. I have linked my formula book in the description as well as in the suggested video above. You can check it out. I would highly recommend you to revise this every weekend because it helps in improving retention of the formulas and ultimately your accuracy rate. Okay, so we are almost at the end of the video, but before closing it, let me show you my quants improvement. So you saw my initial mock scores. At the end, I saw that my average was around 25 attempts and getting 20 questions correct. In the final exam, I attempted 28 questions, but I made a lot of silly mistakes. Fortunately, I was able to score more than 95 percentile, and I still believe that it was probably because of the higher attempt. So I would highly encourage you to work on your attempt strategy first. And one thing that I would want to put across for someone who's not good at QA, never underestimate the power of persistent hard work. I mean, the only thing I did was working hard for a section I wasn't comfortable in. And I believe that if you have determination, then whatever I've shared in the video can give you a structure to follow to improve your score in the section. Ultimately, what I want to say is that it's possible and you can do it no matter which background you come from or whether or not you're strong at QA already. So this is the end of the video, guys. If you have any queries, put them down in the comments. Thank you for watching the video. Let me know how you found it.